I always knew I was gay. I never had a moment where you walk into the room and say, I'm gay, or you go up to a parent and tell them. Part of my culture forbade that. So I think the part of coming out for me was more about me knowing. I always knew I was different. And it was actually my father that would say that I was gay. From a very young age, I'd be called a puff, and I'd be beaten up for being called and for acting like one, even though I had no idea what one was. But I'd get beaten up a lot for being one. And my dad's family at Christmas times used to buy me girls' presents. I used to get treated like a girl to humiliate me into being tougher. I ran away from home when I was in my teens, in my mid-teens. It was because I had to. It wasn't, it was for my own safety, to save my own life, really. I left home as a gay guy. So I suppose everyone else knew I was gay from the age of 15. My family didn't know officially until 3 years later. I wrote them a letter. I wrote my mum a letter telling her that I was. And I asked if she wanted to meet. And I said in the same letter, I asked if she'd want to. And I said that if you did, we could meet in this place, and I gave her two dates and two times and a place to meet me. And and I remember going there to wait for her, and I was there for about 40 minutes, and I just thought, she's not going to show. And I just heard this car horn, and as I looked, there was like this little van on the pavement, and she was sat in the van. She'd just been staring at me the whole time. And when I got in the van, she was hugging me, and she kept taking things out of the back of the van from over the seat. And she'd been saying that she wasn't allowed to talk about me, but she used to write me letters, and she would buy me Christmas presents and birthday presents, and she used to hide them. And she said that she always knew, and she doesn't care what I am, and that I did the right thing, and that she was proud of me. At the time, there wasn't anyone on my side. I just did what I had to do, and what I had to do in a desperate situation, when you're living amongst a culture of people that believe that being gay is not even real, it's a disease from the outside. And so what I had to do was leave. No matter what, no matter how hard that was, I'd not had any experience of the outside. So what I had to do was go. And it took a... God, I felt like I was planning all of my childhood to leave one day. Learning to be and accept that who I was, and that there were other people like me, was the most beneficial thing. Because there's nothing worse than feeling like the only person like you in the world. And what you are, you can't help you are, but everyone hates what that thing is. If there's anything I could have changed... It's difficult, because I think that... After I left home, there are times of being homeless and on the streets, and... feeling like the lowest of the absolute low. And of course, at the time, the thing you want to change is, I wish that your family would just accept that, but you know that that's something you can't change. So I'm going to have to say that I wouldn't change anything, because no matter how crap all of that was, I'd never felt more alive in my life. And it also made me realise what the quality about being gay is. And it's more than being a gay person and being attracted to the same sex. And it's more than, you know, all those kind of numbers of stereotypes of what gay can be. I think there's a great bravery that comes with being a gay person. It's almost a gift. It is a gift. Because you're forced into having to be a strong person. Because you'll never go through your life swimmingly without somebody picking on you or thinking that you're some kind of freak just because of something that's in your bones.
With £25, AKT can provide 24 hours of emergency support, including a safe place to stay for a young LGBT person who has been abused and thrown out onto the streets. Please, give what you can to make sure no young person faces abuse and danger on the streets this winter. You can donate online at www.akt.org.uk/winter.